Deputy Speaker, Deputy President, and honorable members. 2 weeks ago, the President misled the nation during the NCOP question session when he claimed that he was never given an opportunity to present his side of the story by the public protector. We now know with evidence in our hands that this is contrary to the facts as they are also confirmed by the audio version of the report. In normal democracies, this is an act of perjury and punishable through impeachment. Many South Africans have long lost confidence in the leadership of this monumentally flawed president. We also heard from, amongst others, the mouth of the ANC chief whip that many branches of his party have also lost confidence in his leadership and are calling for his removal. President Zuma, the ANC, and the world over must know that South Africans reject to be led by an irreparable damaged leader. However, the ruling clique on this side of the house is behaving like wolves, screaming in unison to defend one of theirs at the expense of the country. They are showing South Africans a middle finger. Look at them, they are jumping from their chairs like popcorns. Another confusion is being made by the party secretary general, who on the one hand calls for his leader to follow his conscience, yet his party members in this house are blocked from thinking.
Honorable member, honorable member, please take your seat. Yes, what's the point of order?
My point of order is that I cannot be called a wolf by a Pantustan general. He must withdraw.
That's not a point of order, honorable member. Go ahead, honorable member.
A Pantustan general
who should
be where you are.
Order, honorable members.
On a point of order, Chair.
Honorable members, allow a member to...
Honorable member, yes. Honorable Chair, in 2009, the ruling was made that to refer to the members to as animals was unparliamentary. So they refer to things like dogs, monkeys, and mules. So we cannot refer to the members of parliament as wolves. Can you rule on that, please?
On a point of order, Chair.
Yes, honorable member.
Chairperson.
Honorable Holomisa, please take your seat.
No, don't worry, I can stand.
No, the rule says you must sit, sir.
Can my leader be protected here? The issue here is that he said like wolves, which is a simile. He didn't call anyone a wolf, yeah.
Yes.
Right? The metaphors, most of us is great out of his speeches because about Abafunu Mamel. Can you ask them to stop rising on frivolous points of orders and allow us to conclude the debate?
Yes.
Because that was a simile for you chaps.
Yes.
He did not call anyone a wolf.
Honorable, I'll rule on that, yeah, honorable. Honorable member. Go ahead. I'll come back to that.
Another confusion is being made by the Secretary General of the ANC, who on the one hand calls for his leader to follow his conscience, yet his party members in this house are blocked from thinking. It begs a question, how many and to what extent are the apex leaders of the ANC are contaminated by the actions of their flawed leader? This crisis is only equal to the collective conscience of all the citizens. In this regard, the UDM calls on all citizens, irrespective of their political persuasions, not to abdicate their historic and fundamental civic responsibilities. We must find a common point of convergence to defend our hard-won democracy.
Honorable Holomisa, your time has expired, sir.
Ningola nje masela ndine uyahamba uzuma niyathanda nithande.
Eh, wena bantu stand general.
Honorable Chair.
The metaphors was often as scratch out of his speeches because abantu bafuna mamel. Can you ask them to stop rising on frivolous points of orders and allow us to conclude the debate? Yes. Because that was a simile for you chaps.
Yes.
He did not call anyone a wolf.
Honorable, I'll rule on that, yeah, honorable member. Go ahead. I'll come back to that.
Another confusion is being made by the Secretary General of the ANC, who on the one hand calls for his leader to follow his conscience, yet his party members in this House are blocked from thinking. It begs a question, how many and to what extent are the apex leaders of the ANC are Deputy Speaker, Deputy President, and honorable members. 2 weeks ago, the president misled the nation during the NCOP question session when he claimed that he was never given an opportunity to present his side of the story by the public protector. We now know with evidence in our hands that this is contrary to the facts as they are also confirmed by the audio version of the report. In normal democracies, this is an act of perjury and punishable through impeachment. Many South Africans, look at them, they are jumping from their chairs like popcorns. Another confusion is being made by the party secretary general, who on the one hand calls for his leader to follow his conscience,
on a point of
yet
order.
His party members in this
point
House are blocked from thinking.
Honorable member, please take your seat. Yes, what's the point of order?
My point of order is that I cannot be called a wolf by a Pantustan general. He must withdraw.
That's not a point of order, honorable member. Go ahead, honorable member.
Be where you are.
Order, honorable members.
On a point of order, Chair.
Honorable members, allow a member to.
On a point of order.
Honorable member, yes.
Honorable Chair, In 2009. The ruling was made that to refer to the members to as animals was unparliamentary. So they refer to things like dogs, monkeys, and mules. So we cannot refer to the members of parliament as wolves. Can you rule on that, please?
On a point of order, Chair.
Yes, honorable member.
Chairperson.
Honorable Holomisa, please take your seat.
Don't worry, I can stand.
No, the rule says you must sit, sir.
Can my leader be protected here? The issue here is that he said like wolves, which is a simile. He didn't call anyone a wolf. Yeah.
Yes. Right?
Have long lost confidence in the leadership of this monumentally flawed president. We also heard from amongst others the mouth of the ANC chief whip that many branches of his party have also lost confidence in his leadership and are calling for his removal. President Zuma, the ANC, and the world over must know that South Africans reject to be led by an irreparable damaged leader. However, the ruling clique on this side of the House is behaving like wolves, screaming in unison to defend one of theirs at the expense of the country. They are showing South Africans a middle finger.